The Korean government announced in early October that we will invest over $360 million in the nation's virtual reality industry. And now there is a growing movement in the country to combine education and VR. Our Kim Jung-soo has more.
It's a rainy Tuesday morning outside, which means that most elementary school students will have to forego their outdoor PE classes. But the students at Oksu Elementary School in Seoul seem undeterred by the rain. This is Korea's first ever virtual reality physical education class. Students here can use the technology to practice their free kick skills. After a student kicks the ball, sensors measure the ball's speed and the force of the kick, displaying both on screen to help teach students how to improve their skills.
With VR, I can compete with other students using virtual characters.
Because the screen shows exactly how well the students have kicked, they can set concrete goals and make measured improvements.
The PE class ends with an impromptu quiz. But unlike an ordinary pen and paper quiz, the students kick or throw the ball towards the right answer on the screen. A bit south of Seoul in Yongin, the developers at VR startup Indigo Entertainment are busy working on new VR content. While the company has produced a variety of products, including shooting games with eye-popping graphics, its most successful project to date has had a distinctly educational bent. Their creation is a virtual tour of one of Korea's most famous historical landmarks, Seokguram Grotto.
Even though you can go to Seokguram and see it, it's still hard to get a comprehensive understanding. So we allowed users to learn and experience Seokguram's story in three perspectives, at ground level, from mid-air, and from outer space.
Further south at the Cognition and Learning Technologies Research Lab at Jeonnam National University in Jeollanam-do Province, researchers are busy looking for new ways of applying VR technology. According to the head researcher, one of the most valuable advantages of VR education is that it allows students to, quote, reorient themselves.
Spatial awareness is a very important part of learning. When you usually learn that there are two objects that are separated by a certain distance, you would simply memorize that fact. But now with VR, we can actually take students to the space in between.
In fact, VR can not only make better students, but also better teachers thanks to classroom simulations like this. Near the set, a supervisor uses a specially designed controller to make the virtual students ask pointed questions, express disinterest, or even dissatisfaction.
I'll be starting my first teacher apprentice program next year. A lot of the education I've had so far have been very theory-based, so this has been really helpful for me.
However, existing VR software and hardware will need to be carefully fine-tuned for educational purposes. Because although VR can incite interest, most students need to be guided through the specific agendas that constitute a formal educational curriculum.
An educator looks to utilize VR in a different way than game developers. Compared to VR games, a productive learning experience should allow for cooperation, experimentation, and constant dialogue.
One effort to optimize VR learning involves the Echo Avatar, or emotional companion, which looks at first virtually identical to the avatars that usually appear in computer games. But Echo doesn't give the user instructions or hints via text or sound, which could interrupt the user's immersive experience. Instead, it quietly tags along as users explore simulated historical sites at their own comfortable pace, while also occasionally leading users into new territory. Experts agree that as of now, the application of VR in Korean education is still in its early stages. But there's no denying that educators are steadily breaking new ground, one simulation at a time. Kim Jung-soo, Arirang News.